Hi everyone, it's Fitz with the Daily Delivery. I hope you're doing well. Let's take a look at that transfer portal on the football side. Now, we've already talked about Fran Fraciolo's tweet about one Power 6 basketball coach saying he's going to stop recruiting high school freshmen, which I'm astonished about. And on the weekend, on Monday, I put something up at GoPowercat from 24/7's Josh Pate talking about tampering with football players in the portal and how the back channel way to get that done through your players, through contacts maybe made in recruiting. You can't just call up a player and say, hey, why don't you come here? That is tampering, but people are certainly doing a lot of back channel contact of players saying, hey, we'd like you to come to school X. And now let's talk about the murky situation at the University of Kansas. And I certainly am not saying that there's any rules being violated here. It's just a little unsettling if you're a school such as Buffalo. Kansas had a great hire in taking Buffalo coach Lance Leipold to be its next head football coach. I think that's a really good choice by KU. And now, as I record this, KU is up to 6 football transfers from his former school, Buffalo. What does this mean for these lesser schools? Not only now are you have to be concerned about losing your coach to a bigger institution, that's just a reality of doing business, but now that coach is going to take a bunch of key players off your roster and simply decimate your program over the spring and summer to help his new program. That's an unsettling development. It's good for Kansas football. There's no doubt about it. Getting a bunch of guys onto the roster that know how to win. Buffalo was successful. They understand the system. They are bought in and they can sell the system to their new teammates. But if you're Buffalo, wow. You just got the double whammy, and this is going to be something that happens all across college athletics now, but it's really going to hit home in basketball. Wait until we have a basketball hire, and that coach takes half of his roster to his new institution. It's coming. It's another time when you can say there's been some impact from this rule that the NCAA didn't really consider, or maybe they simply looked at it and said there's nothing we can do. I don't think you can say that Lance Leipold is tampering with players at Buffalo. Maybe in the true sense of the word you could, but you couldn't prove it. And if those players at Buffalo want to go to Kansas to play for the coach who recruited them, more power to them. It's just a really awkward situation for both Kansas and Buffalo. But I think we all can agree here that the loser here is Buffalo. And it happened twice, a coach and a bunch of players.